Hey, what's going on, everyone? It's Mike again. Today, we're going to talk a little bit about the new Beat Studios. As you can see, I have the red and the white version here. I did an unboxing and first look video on these already before I even went to stores. So you guys got the exclusive first look at them. If you haven't seen that video, go ahead and take a look in the feed. There you'll be able to see the headphones up close and what else comes in the box. Now these headphones are $299, so they're not cheap, but they're the same price as the old studios. Now what's improved is that the new studio no longer requires a pair of AAA batteries. The battery is actually inside the headphone, and you can charge it with the included USB charger. This is what it looks like. It is a 10 watt charger compared to the old charger. The old charger for the Beats Pill and the Beats Wireless looks like this. Looks a little bit cheap and dated. The new charger is a lot nicer. The battery, the internal amplifier, the headphone turns on when you insert the cable, and it turns off when you remove the cable. You can also turn it on from here with the power button. You can also check the status of the battery. So nice added features to the headphones. You can charge the headphones right here with the micro USB charger that's included. The headphones, as you can see, it's a lot more stylish. It's actually a lot smaller than the old Beat Studio. The old Beat Studio looks like this, while the new Beat Studio, it's quite smaller. You know, the old studio is starting to look dated now compared to the new white new studio. Now, the new studio, I really like that it looks a lot better. They're no longer requires AAA batteries. They're very comfortable. The ear pads are very cushy. They block out outside noise quite well, even without the active noise canceling. And when you turn it on, it's very effective. Now there is still a bit of slight hiss sound from the active noise canceling. Not as loud as the old studio and not as loud as the executive. The executive is actually awful. But you do hear the hissing noise. There's a mute button on this side. So when you press the mute button, it fades out the music. And it turns off the active noise canceling. It comes with a iOS Android remote control, very nice remote. They did change the jack itself. The jack is a lot sleeker now, more low profile, better build quality, better strain relief as well. I like that. The new case is also a lot more attractive, smaller than the old case. I like the new case a lot, and you know, it's more sleek. As you can see, you know, the headphones are very attractive. The red I have here is very flashy, so you know, be careful with these, may get you in trouble. You know, they're very comfortable because they're a lot smaller than the old studio. Now the sound quality on these, I find these to be very good, much improved from the old studio. The old studio was very peaky in the highs, a lot of bass, and not very much clarity in the mid-range, very recessed in the mid. The new studio is a lot more balanced. They're going for a flatter frequency response, which I like, but they did not lose the Beats signature. So the Beats magic, I call it. So on hip rap and hip hop music, it still sound very good, very alive, very punchy bass. But just for the first time, the Beats headphones, I can say that you can listen to music outside of rap music on these new studios. So you know, it's a better all around headphone than it was there, or any of the Beats headphones to date. So I think the improvements are quite good. You know, improved sound quality, improved styling, improved comfort. This is a real winner, guys. If this is your first Beats headphone, by the studios. They're much better than any of the Beats headphones. Now the Pros have a sweet spot in my heart. The Pros are really snappy, really punchy. They're still, I think it's still, in terms of build quality and sound, worth the extra $100, but the Studio is the better bargain. Now if you own the old Studio, this is a huge upgrade from the old Studio. I noticed that in the comments of my unboxing videos that people say that the new Studio doesn't sound very good. It's because you have poor quality music. If you listen to higher quality music, higher bit rate, stuff that's not ripped from YouTube or from stolen music, play music from a CD, you'll notice that these are much better sounding headphones than the old Studios. So I like them a lot. I urge you to go check it out. They are worth the $300 in my opinion because of the styling, the sound, and the comfort. So check it out. Thanks for watching my videos. And again, friends don't let friends listen to bad headphones. So go out and listen to some headphones. We'll see you guys next time. Bye-bye.